Hey guys, I'm Captain Duck, and this is Diamond Hollow. It's another Metroidvania Flash game. It's actually on Congregate this time, with this link, which I'll post below. And as always, I found it using metroidvania.com. Also, there's a Diamond Hollow 2, which I'll probably play after this. Anyway, let's play. I haven't done anything of this. I've set my controls with Joy to Key, with the controls below the page, and apparently yeah, it's a mouse game. And this will be hard. I'm using the control in one hand and the mouse in the other hand. Oh fuck, it's auto-scrolling. This is not Metroidvania, it's auto-scrolling. I'm dead. Okay. It's randomly generated. Oh, well that's something. Okay, I thought it would be a normal Metroidvania, but not today. And then apparently getting all the coins is not as important as surviving. dead again. Best just to keep up with them. And I really don't like the control much though. Having a game where you need to shoot with the mouse. Fuck. And do precision platforming as well. Not that precision, you have quite a lot of air time. When you go up, the screen auto scrolls a little bit. That's nice. You're too fast for the game. Also, we're a murderer now. Nice. Some ladders, also achievements. Didn't really need that. Oh, hard to do those short jumps. Oh fuck. Yeah, I'm dead. There's a little upgrade system which I should also probably check when I die. It's just been trying. I'm thinking this is probably a game where you get permanent upgrades. Basically Rogue Legacy style. Huh. So. Gotta be careful. Don't know what I was trying to say there anymore. Oh fuck. And yeah, he pushed me in. Let's take a look at the upgrades. There's a lot here. Okay, I could increase everything. Oh. Or save for the double jump. We have not nearly enough weight. Okay, let's get the double jump first. We have it now, we die now, then that is fine. Also, we just have 3 health, so I just noticed the hearts in the top left. I'll do this once more as a proper run. Oh, that's also a problem with mouse games and action games. If you click out of the window, then it is a pain. I'm guessing getting higher up is better as well, since the blue ones are like another 2, I think. Oh fuck! Well, let's get double jumped. How about the speed and jump upgrade as well? Sure. How's our double jump? Yeah. That makes it a whole lot better. Oh. Now we should be able to survive a whole lot easier. Yeah. And yellow gems. Guess we're getting higher than we've ever gotten before, because I haven't seen a yellow gem before. That would be purple one. That's a lot of ladders. All sort of stakes and ladders references. The achievements. Also, there was an auto fire button, I remember, which I should probably turn on. Nope, too late. What was that button? One second. I'll scroll down. There was somewhere there were instructions. F to toggle auto fire. Okay, this should fix the game. Anything we should buy. Let's get the weapon power to kill more easily. And oh, tool range, sure. Now F is auto fire. Oh, it's not as fast as clicking yourself, though. I will at least save the trouble of clicking the entire time. Just have to move the mouse and focus on the controls. So maybe I should play this with a keyboard instead of the gamepad, but well, this works. It just feels so weird. Oh, fuck. Needy. If I get used to this though, it's probably better than fuck. One hand. Let's get all the cheap upgrades and then we're done. Turrets are the hardest enemy, most annoying one. Okay. I mean, some purple gems. Oh, fuck. Dashing critical. So we can have a crit chance. What's important? Guess and collect to get all the monies. Let's try to get a couple of levels of that to farm more and faster and better. Gems get stuck sometimes. Ooh. A couple of jump upgrades would probably not hurt either. Well, no. Focus for now is on upgrading the collection range a couple of levels. Should have enough for one level. Let's see if we can get two. Starting to scroll faster. Sometimes I have feelings too. Guess I killed a big number of them. Look down. Probably a new height difference. Oh, fuck. Okay, let's collect more gems. And a jump upgrade. Now, yeah, they just fly towards us. In the rough, and yeah. I'm getting achievements, I think, for collecting gems. Or diamonds, even, because the game is called Diamond Hollow. Yeah, sorry not talking much, but trying to do a good run. Yeah, having an upgraded gun is, I think, our next target. Well, let's get criticals. That's it. Expensive ability, but yeah, chance we one hit any enemy. Hello, is that even that good in this game? Probably some flat damage upgrades are better. So you kill them in less hits. That was a terrible run. Let's see, we recorded only 10 minutes of this? Wow. Time flies. Wonder at what point I should move on to the second game, which is supposedly even better according to the Metroidvanias. Where's all the gems? Come on, game. I guess they're just in the slimes. Oof. Concentration. There I go. Let's see. More power. And some things here. Oh well, let's see how much. If we can max the upgrades. Shouldn't be that hard. Especially. I'm collecting things now. Taking the path with the most gems, but survival, that's the game. Survival and slime murder. Fitting you did the slime's turn where you played a slime game the other night, and now we're a stupid hero which kills a ton of slimes. Not any regards. And we died. Let's get dash. Double tapping. You're still vulnerable with dashing, sure. Let's get quick shot. And we shoot faster. That's something which also helps with killing power. To be able to aim like in a direction and have the enemy die. Seems a lot easier when you're going faster. Speedrunning seems to work. Also, I kind of feel more in control when I'm doing that instead of just trying to keep up with the game. That was a tough jump. Let's do more quick shots on the speed. I think we've seen most of the level assets by now. It seems like going by the sort of spelunky design of having certain rooms with a couple of random elements and then stacking them on top of each other. Tube on the left and here in the bottom right. That's the way I do games like these. I That's a lot of money. Ooh, that might have been my death. This is you. Maybe there's more block types which only show up when you're higher up. Some which are near to the beginning. Phew. Oh man. That's tough. Let's get we're a big spender now. A bit more of everything. And I should have also upgraded my collection range to max by now. That's my next target. Looks like we got a lot more air time as well, and the jump height does make a difference. Oh. Okay. Getting a little bit higher. Should check what my record is. Near the 300 meters now. Last run went pretty good. No idea, but no. Height I had. Also, the taps you're hearing, that is me holding the control in one hand and. Oh fuck, I actually died. The other hand touching it. The other side of it touching the keyboard. You know what, let's try without a keyboard for a second. Enough of that. Let's not just use WASD. We have some money to spend. Let's up our collect. 600 for the final level. It's easier on my fingers as well, since I don't have to call the controller. I should maybe just done this from the start. Feels a lot more natural as well. Oh well. Thing is, nowadays I'm pretty used with to use a controller. And for the obvious question, which is bound to be asked, is what controller were you using? I was using a classic PlayStation 1 gamepad, which I have connected to my PC with one of those PlayStation 2 USB cables. It's the best controller there is for precision platforming. If you ask me, really love the PlayStation's D-pad. Just a little bit more for that collect. Come on. That's enough. It's nothing to live for. It knows we just killed ourselves. Tons of achievements. Achieve 9 hearts, 750 meters. Climb 250 meters without killing any enemies. Huh, 1000 meters, 500 enemies. Learn all 51 skills. So I need a seat on my chair here for a second. Okay. Well, we still have stuff to do. So I guess I could try playing, doing a passive run, but. There's no real use, especially since you get so much coins from the enemies. That's just if you want it. It's not like getting an achievement will get me more coins or something which will help me get better in the game. So it's best to be tried whenever you have all the fucking upgrades. Ugh. Nasty. Some cheap ones. There you go. And keep forgetting to look at the high score. I see that it's there, but then I don't talk about it, and then I completely forget it. I'll check next death. I think it was somewhere in the 400-ish. Climbing 250 meters without killing enemies. We won't even be that bad. I'm already at 150. So the achievement again. Still not instant killing all the slimes. Oh fuck. Tons of money. More power. Forget about the starting area, there's tons of gems here, but the real money is to be made higher up, so just go with the flow. Gotta go fast. I think I'm playing much better now with WASD. Then you have to deal with the mouse as well. It's better to just use WASD instead of one-handed gamepad. Oh yeah, what I was trying to say earlier when I died, the PlayStation Control is the best for classic games. Indie games, the D-pad on a PlayStation 1 and 2, and well, actually 3 and 4 as well, probably. 3 and Destiny. Yeah, but it's pretty good, the D-pad. And D-pad is what counts here in games like this. I like it even better more than Nintendo's D-pad, which is pretty good as well, for like ever. But yeah. 1,000 coins, wow. Let's max out power and these sort of things. We're getting closer to maxing all the skills, but I like the PlayStation's like indented control better than Nintendo's little plus D-pad. And you guys don't even talk about the Xbox gamepad D-pad that's been shit forever. Well, maybe the Xbox One D-pad's better, but I doubt that. Okay, getting higher up. Oops, grabbing lots of gems. Genocide! That's the slime killer achievement, I guess. There's no way to regain health either, isn't there? Make long runs like near impossible. I wonder if the slimes also do get more health at higher levels. They seem to die in a couple of hits. But yeah, the gun is pretty powerful now. went for the money all the way. I'm at height 600. Oh, luckily I had the jump height to do that. Otherwise this would have been over. 700 meters. Wow, that's pretty good. Nice. Let's max out jump while we're at it. And quick shot and all these sort of things. Maybe you want to be able to, like, not think about the mouse. Just point it somewhere and... yeah, looks like I'm one-shotting all the things now. Let's try doing another run like we had just now, although I'm already losing all my HP, so that's probably not going to happen. I should upgrade my health. Yep, that will be our next goal. Doing long runs, you need all the HP you can get. All these bullets can get pretty fast. And mini maxed out the fucking entire grid, and let me do that, I'll move on to the next game. So probably see enough of this by now. Also, are kind of getting sick of the dance beat now. It's a pretty nice little music beat, but yeah, it's on infinite loop. That's never a good thing. This gets raining after a while. Said the guy who had his Dwarf Fortress music in all his videos, and it's the same music loop every fucking time. However, Dwarf Fortress music at least had a long, which is like 10 minutes or something, so it doesn't say nearly enough. Also, I've like learned to completely ignore it. The good thing though, the main reason I'm still using that Dwarf Fortress music because it is royalty free, and I don't get into shits on YouTube. Which is important nowadays. I don't want to be having any other music under that, so I don't get, well, my ad money basically. Can't run ads when you do something like that. But still. Having a reasonable run now again. Lots of money. Only one heart left. And there we go. 1800 diamonds. Well, let's get resilience, vitality. Oh, when I relax my eyes for a second, the game keeps scrolling upwards slowly. It isn't, but my eyes are like completely used to the vertical scrolling, which is kind of constant. It's very tough to look at the menu when you're playing an intense game like this. And the scrolling suddenly stops. Hurt yourself if you have no idea what I'm talking about. It's a free game anyway, so yeah, play that. Forget about those gems. No need to. No risky strats for blue and green gems or purple gems even. maybe risky strats for the higher levels of gems. I think the yellow ones are pretty good. The white ones, definitely. Oh, I missed that shot somehow. Also, I'm getting to like 400 meters now and haven't had a single hit yet. I'm definitely getting in the zone. That's pretty good for a game like this and this version. One hit. We've already made 18k. So still trying to set the pace myself. It's just easier when you scroll the screen instead of you get scrolled by the screen. Get my drift. Are we there yet? That's another achievement. So, oh, that's 750 meters. So, yeah. New heights. Yeah, those bullets are getting pretty fast. Would be nice if we could get to 1,000 meters in this run. If we get to 1,000 meters, then this, well, this game is over. What else is there to do? Instead of just min-maxing everything, and looks like we're having an easy time to the 1,000 meters. Nice pace. Nice. That's where our space envoy is. In space. And there we died. Okay, can I max everything now? Yes I can! A winner in WinRars U! Nice. Okay, well that's enough for you. Well, let's have one more little game with our cells at maximum power. And this will be the final one and then we'll move on to the second game. Diamond Hollow number 2. Well, first take a break because my eyes need to rest after all the scrolling. But that's making people in the YouTube will notice that. Game seems to be running better when I'm rambling. Get hit less. Jumping power and speed now. I knew that would work. Going up to the left side like that. Stupid, but okay, we did it. That's enough for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed, and yeah, I'll record Diamond Hollow 2 after this, so you'll look out for that. Anyway, for now, I hope you guys enjoyed again, because my brain is dying, and I'll see you guys later.